Melbourne drivers hit with new 30 kilometres per hour speed limit trial. The world has gone fucking mad. Has anyone out there got a horse and cart that I can buy? Because there's no point having a car in Melbourne anymore.
G'day guys, Roscoe here, Truth in Your Face. That was an excerpt from PK's video in relation to Melbourne's 30 kilometre an hour speed limit trials. So if you haven't seen that video, go check it out. The link to his video is in the description. Also check out his channel if you haven't already do so, subscribe to it. But he explains it very well about how ridiculous a 30 kilometre an hour speed limit is. But I'm just dove into it a little bit further and look at some statistics to see how justifiable this 30k an hour speed limit would be. First we'll talk about bicycles, safety of bicycles. Statistics show that 43% of bicycle accidents occur at intersections. It also shows that 20% of them occur on bypass, which is no button cars. It's a fucking big high number of bicycle riders, 20% accidents on bypass. Learn how to ride your bike. Anyway, so is it fair that if the majority of bicycle accidents happen at intersections, is it fair to reduce the speed limit to 30 k's an hour? No. Because stopping at an intersection has no relevance to the speed limit. The confusion with bicycle accidents occurs when a car pulls out of a street or pulls out in front of a bike. And that's why they mostly occur at intersections. Now, pedestrians. So firstly, I went to the Vic Roads website and they told me that 47 pedestrians are killed each year. So I went and looked up the Bureau of Statistics, and this is what it gives me. The last 5 years. Vic Roads, I think you are lying. Or you need to update your website. So I went and looked at detailed statistics. The last 5 years, starting at 2012, there were 8 pedestrian deaths that occurred in 50k an hour zones. And none of them involved children. 2013, in the 50k an hour zone, we had 7 fatalities of pedestrians and 0 kids. Anyway, we'll keep going. 2014, there was no fatalities in the 40k zone, which is good. There were 7 fatalities in the 50k zone, one of them being a child. 2015, 7 fatalities in the 50k zone, 2 fatalities in a 40k zone. None of them were children. In 2016, there was 5 fatalities in a 50k zone, none in a 40k zone. And none of those 5 in the 50k zone were kids. No fatalities in the 40k zone. Brings us to 2017. 50k an hour had 5 fatalities with 1 child. But there were 3 fatalities in a 40k zone and none of them were in a school zone. None of them involved children. So, reducing the speed limit from 40 to 30, is it justifiable? 7 fatalities over 5 years in a 40k zone. 1 of the fatalities was a child. So is it justifiable to reduce the speed limit from 40 to 30? Do the figures show that there is a problem? PK's got the right idea. Horse and cart, here we come.
Hope this has been informative for you. I'll catch you next time. Bye bye.